Welcome back. Day three. This is Pastor Craig on our two-week journey of approaching God through prayer and evaluating and being challenged to be disciple makers. So, we've been looking at the Great Commission basically for 2 days, and I want to move into the book of Acts today. So again, go to the website, get the link. You can figure out how to do that through our website, and I'm sure there'll be a link on this page, but I'm going to have you read from Acts chapter 1 today, verses 6 through 11. And I know that a lot of these are they're not the full context of stories. We're just trying to really hone in on some key things that Jesus is saying to his disciples about making disciples. And so feel free to read more of the book of Acts as you go through the journey. But today's focus is in chapter 1. And this is where Jesus is calling his disciples his witness. He calls them his witness. And they're supposed to go out basically, and he's urging them to share the things that they've seen. Now, we don't get the privilege of walking with Jesus in flesh. We actually get the privilege of walking with the Holy Spirit dwelling in us, which is an amazing gift that God gives us. And Jesus, before he left, said, look, I have to go. You can't go with me yet, but I am going to give you something. I'm going to give you the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit goes with us and is part of transforming us. See, without the Holy Spirit, we would be doing all this on our own. We'd be trying to be good and do good things. But the Spirit is what is inside us that challenges us and grows us and through his word impacts us, right? And transforms us. Now, that transformation is evidence in your life that Jesus is real, that God is real, and the Holy Spirit is working in you. So that Holy Spirit is what we need to transform us. But the key here was to go and share the things you've seen. So I want to challenge you today to be thinking about your own testimonies. If you're going to be a disciple maker, if you're going to share the gospel, well, hopefully you've been impacted by the gospel and you're being transformed. So there's three key things to be thinking about today. Take some time and write down these three key areas, and you'll see them in the notes here if you want to look at that. But the first one is, make a list of your life before Christ. What were you like before you surrendered your life to Jesus? What was your life like? What were the actions and attitudes in your life? The second one is, how did you come to this place where you decided and God impacted you to a point where you surrendered? What does that look like? Were you with somebody? Were you being discipled with somebody? Were you alone in your room and God just intervened into your life? What does that look like? And then number three, how are you being transformed today? If you were to compare pre-Jesus to now following Jesus, how are you being transformed and how have you been transformed? Really critical part. See, if we're going to share the gospel, if we're going to make disciples, I think we better have an understanding of what the impact is in my personal life. What does it look like? Because nobody can deny the changes. And it's kind of a cool journey when I interact with people that knew me prior to my coming to faith. They've said, there's something different about you. There's something different. Well, hopefully that's a good different, not just a weird different. But it's a good different. They said, there's something about you. And I've noticed in my own life, just a heart of caring for people that I can't explain, that can only be the Spirit working in me, because honestly, I'm selfish, I'm a human, and I want to have everything for me, but the Spirit is really prompting me through my life as I grow to be more like Jesus, to be more caring like Jesus is. That is a daily challenge, though. I mean, honestly, it's what it means to be a human, I think. So here's our prayer focus. There's only a couple questions. Not really questions. They're just prompts to get you thinking to go into a time of prayer. So set aside some time, isolate yourself, pray with somebody, get together, whatever. But here's kind of the focus. As you go before God, spend time today thanking God for the changes that you are seeing in your life. I think it'd be great if you're a follower of Christ to not only write down the changes, but to give God glory and thank him for what he is doing in your life. So there's another prompt there. I'll let you read that on your own. I hope that in day three, there's this awareness that to be a disciple maker, I'm gonna have to be a disciple, a good disciple of Jesus, a follower of Jesus, not only in words, but in action as well. So here you go. Good luck and enjoy your prayer time today.